Good afternoon from Northern Ontario, just south of the Hudson Bay, where it's nice and sunny outside. That makes us happy, happy, happy up here. Welcome to this week's episode of Believe TV. My name is Chad Hymas, and I'm sitting here from Northern Ontario, the Victor Mine site, where we've been here most of the week doing some leadership training. And today I want to talk to you about your shape. When we talk about shape, in my world, we're not talking about necessarily your physique or how good a shape you're in or the exercise that you do. But rather, shape is an acronym that stands for the following. It stands for spirituality, stands for heart, the H would be for heart, A is ability, P is personality, and E is your experiences. And I want to break that down for you a little bit today and have you write that down in your office or in your journal or on your wall. Write down the word shape. This is a great way to measure your progress each day, a great way to measure your contributions each and every day to the world and to society around you. So let's start with S, spirituality. The S always reminds me to remember that I'm not necessarily a human being having spiritual experiences, but that I'm a spiritual being having human experiences. And when you keep that focus, things tend to be more perspective in your life each and every day. The H is for heart. Each one of us has been given a different heart. Each at a different pace. Some are big, some are small. How you guys doing? I got friends all over the place here. Some of your hearts are big, some of your hearts are small in size, but no matter what size your heart is physically, you all can determine on how much you give with your heart. And so I want you to take a look at your heart each and every day. The A is for your abilities. Each one of us have different God-given abilities. We've been blessed with different things, physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, financially, we've been given different things. Take a look at those abilities and see what you can do to give and bless the lives of other people. The P is an important one. Personalities. We all have different personalities. Some have stronger personalities than others. In fact, there's even different types of assessments on the internet that you can take to see what kind of a personality you have. Red, blue, green, white, whatever the color might be. Whatever your personality is, see what your strengths are, focus on those strengths. Whatever your weaknesses are, see what you can do to improve those. And finally is the E in the acronym SHAPE. E is for your experiences. Each one of us have different experiences. Are you recording those in a journal? Do you blog about them on the internet so that we can all learn from those things? Are you willing to share your experiences with other people so that we can benefit? How about the experiences that we see of other people that are happening on television? I'm not talking about soap boxes or different TV shows or reality TV, but I'm talking about, well, I've been watching the news and seeing what's going on in Colorado and watching how the acronym SHAPE fits into the lives of each of those people that we lost, and also how the acronym SHAPE has been the lives of those that are still remaining and those that are benefiting those that they've lost. Notice I use the word benefit, not loss. We lost 12 people in Colorado this last Thursday night, Friday morning. We need to place a value on that and be better people for it. And I think it's in our best interest to not judge. Let that take care of itself. And the SHAPE for each one of us will improve. Until next week, believe you can fly. Thank you for joining us on Believe TV. Next week, we'll contact you from somewhere in the U.S. I'm not quite sure where that is, but I'll be down in the lower 50 next week. Take care, and we'll see you then.